If you wanted to play Saina Nehwal and if my producer agreed, I would have made you Saina Nehwal. So there's no big deal for me.
मैंने अभी एकेडमी बनाई थी तो सोचा था कि यहाँ से चैंपियन निकले। साबुन तेल बेचने के लिए मेरी ट्रेनिंग की जरूरत थोड़ी है।
कोई चाय की टपरी पे कोल्ड ड्रिंक के साथ अगर फोटो खिंचवा के लटकना है तो मेरे यहाँ आने की जरूरत नहीं।
When Shraddha Kapoor backed out because of many reasons and you chose Pariniti Chopra.
Shraddha, she started shooting with me, which means she was ready for the role.
Yeah.
Which means she had put in a year full of practice.
Yeah.
To play that role.
Number one के सपने पालना खतरे से खाली नहीं होता.
Once she became world number one, I had to make a film about her.
Yeah.
I did most of the paintings in Tare Zameen Par, the boy with the gola in the mouth, and the soldier exiting from the tunnel.
पूते में हाथ तूने काटा क्या?
आज से तेरा किस्सा खत्म और मेरी कहानी शुरू।
Everybody looks at me as a villain. I don't know why. Though I make films with children and now thankfully it's come on to Amazon and people are at home and they are watching it. I like it when I cook or I make tea, chai.
मेरा ध्येय एकदम सरल, सामने वाले को मार देना।
So we have with us writer-director of Saina. As you all know, it's the latest movie of Pariniti Chopra and is a biopic of badminton superstar Saina Nehwal. And Mr. Amol Gupte is with us. So first of all, let's welcome him. Sir, welcome to my show.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much. And good morning to everybody there in Atlanta.
Yes.
It's evening here, dusk in Mumbai.
Yeah, we are going to talk about your directorial and, you know, as a writer, you've come up with Saina, but you're also an actor and your Mumbai saga is also been releasing on Amazon Prime
today.
Yes. So
it
we are going to talk about
today.
That also. Yeah, we are going to talk about everything, but let's start with Saina first. So, sir, because of the COVID, as we all know that the release been pushed from September 2020 to March 2021, it released in theaters, but again COVID came and now it's on Amazon Prime. So how is the response so far?
It was actually meant for the theaters because it has badminton matches, it has got stadiums full of people and it's exciting to see it on a large screen with a good Atmos mix. And I really, really put a lot of time on the soundtrack of the film so that it could be a big theater experience.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, within the week of that release, anyway, on the day of the release too, we were going through red alerts of COVID rising. You know, it was rising in a big way.
Yeah.
That's before 26th March. The 26th March was the release of the film.
Right.
And then we could not extract because we said, Kip, we don't know whether the theatres will open.
Yeah.
So these are troubling times.
Yeah.
So what else? How long to wait for the release? There's a pipeline of big starers ready and waiting.
Yeah.
So then what to do? So it's better to take that chance. Then unfortunately, we decided through the date open and put it into the theatres and exponentially Corona rose in Maharashtra and all around. Within a week there was a lockdown, so within a week of its release theaters and malls had to be shut because of the fear of the spread. Kare kya baithe rahe kya. And now thankfully it's come on to Amazon and people are at home and they are watching it and I'm getting a tidal wave of response because it's a family film. It's a motivational film. And it's a positive film in these negative times.
Yeah.
So, in a way, it kind of works on people's hearts and minds. And they are wholly supporting it now that it is on Amazon Prime Video. And it's, I think, in about 260 countries simultaneously. So, I'm thankful that at least it has reached the eyeballs and the hearts.
And people are watching
And people are watching it and giving me a fabulous response in terms of overwhelming and how much I wept and how together we held hands and wept, and we were so inspired, and this and that. So I'm lucky.
Yeah, when I got the confirmation that, you know, I'm going to interview you, the first thing I did, I watched the movie. And, you know, it's such a treat to our eyes, and such a nice and inspirational movie. One, because it has a very inspirational story backing up, but also how you executed it. But one troll or one controversy which surrounded it was the trailer. When its trailer launched, people trolled it. People said it's not a good movie, and you know, all sort of kind of thing. But when, and it actually, honestly, my perception as well was the same. I didn't like that, or I would say that trailer didn't justify the movie that
the film is. absolutely
different. See, because when I watched the movie, it's absolutely different. It's absolutely stunning, and the trailer didn't justify that. So how do you think trailer is important to get the first
what I feel is, you're so right, because I always am faced with this puzzling situation, because if I were to be understanding something which has to be told in 3 minutes, then I wouldn't be a filmmaker who requires 2 hours to say something. So that's not my speciality, or that's not my skill to understand trailers. And so I kind of believed my the people who are marketing the film, which is the people who are distributing and producing in terms of finance. And they liked the trailer, because they created the trailer. So I said, guys, you know it. You all produce about 20, 25 films a year. I don't know that craft. Otherwise, I would not be making a film. I would be making promos and trailers and ad films and, shorter attention sharpness, which is required in trailers and promos. I don't possess that skill. So I didn't want to interfere and say, how's it looking, and what I genuinely did not respond in terms of panic. This is not giving the film its worth in its trailer form. And thankfully, or whatever, either ways, there is absolutely no footfall during Corona time. So you cannot attribute the loss of revenue to the trailer. You have to attribute the loss of revenue to the disease. So when you see this, you feel, okay, people are in their houses, and the OTT has reached their houses.
They can watch on Amazon.
By default, they're going to watch the film.
Yeah.
So whether it's trailer or not, you didn't like the trailer, but you watched the film.
Yeah.
Not because, only because you were interviewing me, you would have somehow managed to see the film.
Yeah, definitely. I would have seen it.
Yes. So I'm banking on that.
So now I'm going to ask you a very basic question, sir. I think you've been answering this question for so long, but the basic question is why you chose Saina Nehwal as your first biopic. Why her?
No, this is my first and last. Actually, I've been making only biopics. If you see, Ishan Nandkishore Awasthi in Tare Zameen Par is a portrait of a real child with learning differences, which we call dyslexia. So also Stanley, the little boy from Stanley Ka Dabba, is a poor child who I have seen thousands of them, and I've condensed it into one portrait.
Wapas karo Stanley, wapas karo. Tiffin box kahan hai tumhara? Ye bhai hamesha dusron ke dabbe mein haath dal ke khata hai. Kya hai?
आलू पराठा
लाओ
जल्दी से इसको चख ले चटकारे लेके डोल.
Just like I condensed about 1,000 Ishans into Tare Zameen Par portrait.
That goes for you as well, Ishan Awasthi. Page 38, chapter 4, paragraph 3. Ishan!
Right.
Hawa Hawai is a child of a dead cotton farmer who's died in the agrarian crisis of India. This is 2008, 2009. So I was reacting to that crisis. So that is also a portrait.
Right.
So this also doesn't, this is just because we all know Saina Nehwal. It becomes a biopic. Suppose we didn't know Saina Nehwal. So I would have researched a human being and understood the social circumstance of that person, the emotional pitch and depth of that person, and written the tale. In Saina, thankfully, in 2015, in April, she became world number one.
Yes.
And I had been following her for 5 years before that, mm-hmm. which means right from the Commonwealth Games where she won the gold in 2010 in Delhi, I've been following her growth chart. And in 2015, she became world number one.
Yeah.
Apart from the 2012 Olympic bronze and other things at London Olympics. Once she became world number one, I had to make a film about her.
Yeah.
So it is not because biopics were the season. Actually, biopics were not the season in 2015.
Yeah, it was.
I brought it into season, but because it got announced end of 2015 that I'm making a film on Saina Nehwal. Today it is 2021. I've given 6 years of my life for this wonderful story of this winner girl of India. Yeah, I'm very proud of that.
Yeah, of course. There is a story to tell, and Saina Nehwal's the whole journey, the whole life, the body of her work is inspirational. And now let's come to the point when Shraddha Kapoor backed out because of many reasons, and you chose Pariniti Chopra. So now my question is, why Pariniti Chopra?
It was not mine. See, I have a producer, Mr. Bhushan Kumar, who has stood by me. Be it rain, storm, thunder, he has stood like a solid supporter for this project Saina, which we began in 2015.
Right.
And Shraddha unfortunately had dengue, and she had lost all her strength in her feet and her hands. And it's a biopic on a sports person.
Right.
So we were waiting, and then she was she had other commitments which she had to honor, like Chichore was.
And because, ABCD3.
No, that was my own producer, Bhushan Kumar's film. So, because there was a crisis in that film where Katrina Kaif was meant to play and then she didn't. So, that crisis, my producer solved by taking Shraddha Kapoor there, because there she doesn't require to be like fit like a sports person.
Right.
You know? And it's a much bigger film with Varun Dhawan in terms of costs.
Yeah.
And he was in a crisis. Mm-hmm. And happily, I agreed because he gave me Pariniti Chopra instead.
Oh, I see.
Okay. So, I don't even audition children. You know that.
Yeah.
It's a leap of faith for me.
Yeah.
If you wanted to play Saina Nehwal and if my producer agreed, I would have made you Saina Nehwal. So, there's no big deal for me. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I have tacit faith in every human being that they can act. And they can, because I'm there to not guide, but I'm there to, you know, collate with the actor, get the right tone and the right pitch. Actually, both are fantastic actors. I have no reservations about both the actors who were, because even this one, Shraddha, she started shooting with me, which means she was ready for the role, which means she had put in a year full of practice to play that role.
Yeah.
So it's that way. I'm very, very easy with actors. I don't, I know they can deliver. So I don't have apprehensions.
Or probably you have confidence in yourself that I can, you know, make anyone act.
It's not about that.
Yeah.
It's not some magic wand, you know. It's about human beings only.
Yeah.
So it's the way you hold somebody's hand and take him or her through the role. That's the code and not some magic potion, you know?
Yeah, yesterday when I was watching the movie, and you won't believe I was crying, and my husband said, "Are you crying in this scene?" I was like, "Yes," because I have a daughter. And when there was a scene of her daughter and mother, they were hugging, and that was an emotional rush, you know, that was such a beautiful moment to portray, and how you resonate that feeling to audience, and they start crying, they start relating that things in their lives. And my daughter was sitting in front of me, and I was looking at her, and I was looking at the screen, and I was crying. And my husband said, "Oh, wow, you're crying." I said, "Yes, it's a moment, and it's a beautiful moment."
Yeah.
So yeah, that's the beauty of the movie. So let's now talk about Mumbai Saga, sir. Because it's one thing which I think you've been also waiting for, and this is a totally different character you're playing. Here you're playing an actor. So tell us something about that.
Mumbai Saga was down my lane because I'd already done something like that in Vishal Bhardwaj's Kameene.
Yeah.
And I don't know why, but even I cast myself in Stanley Kadabba as a villain also.
Stanley, main tumse baat kar raha hu, nazar upar. Upar dekh. Tak. Na. Badagal. Get out.
So everybody looks at me as a villain. I don't know why. Though I make films with children, and my understanding and emotive requirement is way different than a villain's is. But I'm always offered these very bad man roles. I don't know why. But I can... I've been a theatre actor. For me, it is a trick from an earlier book. Mm-hmm. And I employ it in trying to give a new spin to the character that I'm playing. And I just like the films that I make, every 3-4 years.
Yeah.
Even acting, I do one role every 3-4 years. Last was Singham Returns, which was in 2017. Mm-hmm. 14, sorry.
14, yeah.
Baji Rao Singham. Bahut suna hai.
Kuch sawal karne the.
Yaar, koi jawab dhoond nahi aata hai.
Lekin fark hai. Aapke bhakton ka jawab nahi milta, to unhe problem ho jati hai. Yahan mujhe mere jawab nahi milenge, to aapko problem hogi.
So it is like, yeah, so it's about 7 years ago. I was in Singham Returns.
So I was watching the review of Anupama Chopra, and she said something about you. She didn't say anything good about any actor, but she said the only actor who showed some spark was Amol Gupte, played a gleeful gangster, and he's having fun.
पूते का हाथ तूने काटा क्या?
कह तो दे, आज से तेरा किस्सा खत्म और मेरी कहानी शुरू।
So she is most respected critic and journalist, and when she was reviewing Mumbai Saga, she only praised you. So how do you feel about that?
I respect her opinion, and that makes me feel very good about myself because she has heaped me with praise. Having said that, I also feel that when I step out to act, I don't carry any baggage. Hmm. Because I don't have any survival instinct. I should survive in the industry as an actor or such things. Neither as a director. I don't really care so much.
Yeah.
So, since I don't have any anything to lose, so when you have nothing to lose, you can do the best things in life.
Yeah.
And you can have a picnic. For me, it's a outing. Every time I go out to act,
I'm having fun.
Yes, I am.
So, sir, out of all these roles, you know, director, writer, and actor, which one you love the most? Or you like obtain it the most?
I like it when I cook or I make tea, chai. Because the chances are that if you make good chai, good tea, then you'll make a good film or you'll do a good role.
Really? How is that?
Yes, yes. Because that is the process. That is how intense your life should be. From making tea or folding towels to everything. It should have a certain grace, which you see in the Japanese people. How nicely they pack their things when they're on display or for sale. How there's a grace and there's a poise in that. So I follow that. So as an actor, as a writer, as a filmmaker, I'm also a painter. For 15 years of my life, I only painted and exhibited and earned from that and, ran my family. And I did most of the paintings in Tare Zameen Par, which you see in the film, of course.
Oh, you did that.
And not Ishan's face. Mm-hmm. And not Ishan's painting, but everything else, all of Ishan's work, which is shared by Nikum to his parents and other things.
Oh,
this is
even
that's besides the point. The flip book and
Oh,
The flip book, of course, it's a device. It's I didn't invest in drawing everything. Mm-hmm. But all the other paintings, the boy with the gola in the mouth, and the soldier exiting from the tunnel, and all those paintings. But you have to see it in the context that I was painting through the hands of a 8-9-year-old child to the world.
Yeah, because your Facebook post is very family oriented. You talk about your mother, your son, Partho.
Because I have only friends on Facebook. Mm-hmm. I don't have a single non-friend. A person who I don't know is not on my Facebook. Oh. It's not like requests are just being accepted so that you get more likes and all that.
Yeah. Because
it's not about
you know, when
I don't have followers on Facebook. I have friends on Facebook.
Oh. That's why I'm lucky. Because I'm your Facebook friend, and since we are talking about it, sir, you wish me birthday every year.
Yeah, because that's the idea of being on Facebook. Is try to make it personal. Yes.
So let's come back to Saina now. What's your favorite dialogue of the movie? Because everyone is praising the dialogues of the movie. That's they are really inspiring and everything.
There are some nice one lines which I have not written. Amitosh Nagpal has written some of those lovely lines for Rajan sir, Manav Kaul's character.
Yeah.
कि अगर तुमको कोई चाय की टपरी पे कोल्ड ड्रिंक के साथ अगर फोटो खिंचवा के लटकना है तो मेरे यहाँ आने की जरूरत नहीं, मेरी ट्रेनिंग की जरूरत नहीं. एंड द किलर लाइन इज दैट डर इस बात का नहीं है कि तुम बड़े सपने देखो और पूरे ना हो जाए, डर तो इस बात का है कि छोटे सपने देखो और वो पूरे हो जाते हैं.
वो पूरे हो जाते हैं. दैट्स योर
Yeah, so that I feel is a very lovely line written by Amitosh.
Okay, sir. In the end, if you want to say something to your fans, you know, if you want to shout
what
out.
What fans? I am. I don't. I'm not from that zone of fans and things. I'm a simple human being. Whoever's looking at this bearded man talking to this wonderful woman, ki bhai, aao and come and. Take a taste of both Mumbai Saga and of course our Saina, which will, if you are a diaspora population in the US of A, then it will really, really give you a scent of the flavor of your land, and you can revisit the Indianness in it and feel proud about Saina Nehwal, who became world number one in April 2015. That's a rare moment in Indian sport.
And thank you so much, sir, for talking to us. And it was wonderful, wonderful chatting to you.
No, God bless you. Take care, be safe, wear your masks. And these are troubled times, so don't lose hope. Be positive. God bless.
Thank you so much, sir. Yeah! And another one for Saina Nehwal.
This is what you mean to the sport.